You all are one step closer to $100,000. You got the pressure off your back for the first round. Should be feeling good. Should know the road, right?
Yeah.
So, Larry, this is my opinion. I think you probably made the fastest pass of the round. That's just my opinion. Your was flying.
That's one.
But then again, my opinion don't mean, but that's just how I feel. Chief, the monkey is off your back.
That's Dave standing.
Yeah, I'm where Dave's supposed to be.
You got the Dave monkey off your back.
Now all I gotta do is win this whole, and I'll be good.
I feel like the stars are aligning right now. In Nebraska, of all places.
The corn is aligning.
Yeah, so. All right, let's draw for the next round.
Now you know I can't reach in that bag and hang them tall.
There, now your turn.
Mix them up real good. I don't want any of the guys I'm standing next to.
No.
It's mutual.
The first driver's meeting, I was Dave, and I drew him.
Get it. I got two of them.
My lucky number. I hope nobody else has got my lucky number.
All right, number ones, where you at? Get out here. Who you racing? Robin? Who you racing?
I don't know.
Who's racing Robin? Number one. Number one.
You gotta be kidding me.
I'm standing right there. It didn't make a difference.
Damn. Why, dude? Why?
Everybody I'm standing next to in the garden, man, I got race, I guess.
Why would you do that?
Well, because I was standing next to Dave in the first one, and I drew him. So I was standing next to Robin, so I walked over here.
All right, number twos. Where you at? All right. Silver unit. Or silver Camaro. Good luck, brother. All right. Remember, tame it down a little bit. A little less wheel speed. Just a little bit. All right, where are my threes? Larry Larson.
This ought to be entertaining.
Jake Blaine. Which means Mr. Tony is racing Trish. Y'all doing any side bets on this? What y'all doing?
Oh,
he said, sky's the limit. Sky's the limit.
500?
That's good.
500?
Number ones. Get together. Meet me back here shortly. All right? Let's go.
Bracket 3's remaining 8 drivers are one step closer to moving on in the winner's bracket. And with drivers like Daddy Dave and Mike Murillo already losing tonight, nobody wants to get knocked down to that loser's bracket. Big Chief took care of business first round and will start us off in round 2 against Robin Roberts.
Hey, Robin, you want to flip for lane?
Gonna do it now?
Yeah, if you want to, since we're first. I don't have one. You got a coin, Millie?
Who's calling it? Who's calling it?
We'll drill further.
Man, I feel like you called it last time, too.
Okay. Heads.
I don't ever win this.
Me neither.
It's tails.
There you go. I'll pull up the one you ain't in.
Yeah. Good luck.
Thank you, fellas. We get through this round, that's it, huh?
We're good. We're in the winner's bracket.
I'd put some in and out the back.
I did that.
Okay.
But what about on the starting line? I mean, has anybody been leaving hard?
I haven't been up there. Well, she got the video of Robin. He didn't leave that hard, and it just, you know, purposed up. But Larson made a killer hit, and he's tuning his car right now. So, I mean, I might put a little bit in it. I mean, we got to swing for it.
Well, then we get the big bat, I guess. The first round chip draw, I was standing next to Dave, and I got him. So in the second round chip draw, I stand in the driver's meeting, I'm looking around, and I'm thinking, I'm standing next to Larry Larson and Robin Roberts, both guys I've seen test, they both made good hits, they're both fast. I don't want either one of them. So my move was to go all the way to the end of the line, because that's the guy I wanted. Turns out, doesn't matter where I stand, I'm gonna get the guy that I was standing next to. I'm gonna get the faster guy, either way.
What? Well, I've known Chief longer than anybody here, so I don't like racing Chief. I also know that he's in his element.
You know, I hate drawing anyone from the 405, and what do? I draw a Doc, then Chief. You know, we just go back a long history here, and now I have to race him. So we've got a tune in it. Should be a winner, but he's also going to step up his stuff. He's a smart guy. And we just got to do our thing.
I got 100 on Chief. He took that one. I got 100 on Chief.
tape. I got a hot and on chief.
He touched the white line, but he didn't cross, from what I can see. This is him right here.
Right here.
And this right there. All right, all right, all right, all right. Left lane by two. Left lane by two, no cross, no cross. No cross, no cross. Thank you.
It is what it is.
Yeah, it is what it is. Hey, but it ain't like, it's not like him to lift, even though Robin's coming after him. Even if Robin's coming after
him. It ain't like me to lift, that's for sure.
Did you?
Hell no.
Okay, so, but I'm saying you know him better than anybody does. You think he lifted because somebody's coming over at him? I never know him to do that. Or did something go on with the car or what?
I mean, I'm not going to say he didn't, but after Chucky hit him, I know it's always on his mind.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I honestly believe that he was up in front of him enough that Chief saw him come over, and it looked to me like he dumped out of it. That's what it looked like to me, that he dumped out of it whenever he saw him coming over. So, I mean, you can be king big, stay in it and go for it, or you can lift and save your ride.
Yeah. Unless you go through a crash like he went through, you don't know what you're
100%.
That would probably work. Honestly, I don't know what I was thinking. I mean, I don't know. That's not me. Normally, somebody comes over into my lane, I drive right through them. I'll brush up against them. I'll hit the wall. I'll hit whatever. Normally, I don't give a I don't know what. I don't know what I was thinking. I honestly don't. About halfway down, both cars were making a solid lick. It was a drag race. And then I just see his car making a hard move towards my lane. And I don't know. Something inside told me to let off. So I pulled up off the pedal. I figured he would correct it, let out, wait till he got back in his lane and get in it, and then I could go right by. I pulled up off the pedal just a little bit, and he just stayed right on that line, and I don't know, man. Me.
Well, there's a positive side to it.
What would that possibly be?
Car's still there in one piece.
That's ugly. I don't know why I lifted. I have nothing to lose in that situation. The one guy, I have the ugliest, most piece of car here. You could rebuild that car tomorrow in a parking lot. And the one guy here who has the most beautiful car and all the money in the world and the nicest guy ever who would probably buy me a car if he hit me. You know what I mean? That's the kind of guy he is. He's that awesome. And the one guy like that, and I let off. I don't know. I have no idea why. Damn, dude. What a I feel so bad for Jackie and Lutz. They've been working their ass off. All I have to do is stay in.
Here's the positive. Here's another one. It's not over yet.
Feels like it.